It's here in the grotto that the shark can discover the absolute serenity deep within her soul. Shark Hunter is the only thing keeping tourists from a nasty, horrible death, outside of just avoiding the beach for a few hours. The powers of society have retaliated with deterrent action, but mankind is ultimately impotent to stop Mother Nature's vengeance. Okay. Upon using this medication, if you experience priapism, do not attempt to improvise your own surgical shot. The grotto provides a brief respite from the Sturm und Drang of the Gulf. A shark will hurl itself at anything that floats. Shark hunting was prohibited by royal decree in ancient Fiji. But this is decidedly not ancient Fiji. There's way more liquor stores and payday lenders.
Should have brought my fish line.
Another shark hunt draws to a close. Everything about the bull shark is custom made toward survival. Over the course of a bull shark's life, it will ingest quite a broad assortment of flotsam and jetsam. That human and shark must so often meet as enemies. This shark is a sort of super scavenger, completely lacking in what may be called dietary discrimination. Fort Clovis has grown bored of the hunt, leaving our shark to fight another day. The shark returns to the grotto to focus on personal transformation. Sapphire Bay's famous Pier 1 provides visitors with plenty of skee ball, popcorn shrimp, and elegantly airbrushed t-shirts. Thank you. Once more, the shark turns back to this place of centered calm. Long a haven for small government ideologues, Port Clovis prides itself in its lax amusement park safety standards. Not really a gourmand, the bull shark will eat just about anything. While homeless and itinerant, hobos will work for a living. They are not to be confused with bums, who are sedentary and refuse to work, like my son Jeff. No one can tell what may be found in a shark's stomach. It's truly the ocean's garbage can.